See, regarding the horticulture, your course teacher would have covered the pomology and as well as the most of the tropical fruit crops. Now I am going to refresh you some of the tropical fruit crops. Let us see the first mango. You jot down the only important points on that. Afterwards, we'll jot down the important points while I am taking a lecture on that. So, mango is king of the fruits. It's called the king of the fruits. And the botanical name, it is Mangifera indica. And this also comes under the national fruits of India. The family is Anacardiaceae. The specialty of the Anacardiaceae is the inflorescence contains both type of flowers, the male flowers as well as hermaphrodite flower, that is called Andromonaceous. So underline that Andromonaceous. The origin is also very important, is Southeast Asia, preferably India, maybe the Indo-Burma, maybe the origin of a mango. And you take this in India, the scientist who has contributed much in mango research is Dr. Singh. He also published a monograph in mango. So mango is strictly evergreen tree crops, and the fruit is a climatic one, and the fruit is called fleshy drupe. The appearance of the panicle is terminal, and near about in a terminal each inflorescence contains more than 1,000 flowers may be there. The since it is Andromonaceous, the chief pollinator is a housefly. And you take that the area and production, it has been given in the PowerPoint. India ranks first among the world mango producing countries. The other countries, China, Thailand, Pakistan, Indonesia and all. And the major growing states, you see that the Uttar Pradesh contributes 23% and Andhra Pradesh 15%, followed by Karnataka, Telangana, Bihar and so on, and also Tamil Nadu. And the purpose for which they are producing as a market, we can consume as a desert fruit, as a fresh mangoes and even a processed mangoes. That also can be exported to the foreign markets. Nearly about more than 1,500 varieties are being evolved in our country. The major varieties, if you see, there are two types of classification. They go for the North Indian varieties as well as South Indian varieties. If you take the South Indian varieties, Neelam, Bangalore, Sindura, Malgova, Rumani, these are all of Salem, Bangalore, these are all comes under South Indian. Whereas if you go to North India, we can get Alfonsa and this Chausa, Sindhu, Dashri and Himayudin, Himabasant. These are all the important varieties of this North India. If you want to go to for export purposes, Alfonsa is the chief exporter. But one of the problem in that the Alfonsa is spongy tissues. To overcome what they have done it, I will tell you then. And the choice varieties, you can go for Himabasant, is one of the choice varieties. And the shy bearer, if they ask, means you can talk about, give example for the mango. See, though it is a monoembryony, there are polyembryony also present in the mango. What are the polyembryony varieties? Which is Nucella seedlings that is used for uniform rootstocks. Ullur, Papakai. These are the two polyembryony varieties. And if you want to tell some of the choice varieties, I mean some chance seedlings which are obtained is Chinna Swarnareka, which are actually used for breeding purpose also. Based on the ripening, we can also classify it early season, mid-season and late season. Probably in the early season, you can see this the Kesar, Swarnareka, Bombay Green comes. Normally our varieties comes in the mid-season. Alfonsa will come up earlier, Bangalore, Banganapalli, that will become here. And northern varieties, Langra, that will come. Whereas in late varieties, we specifically became very season, Neelam, comes under Malgova, is the. And Fazili, that is the North Indian varieties. And nowadays, The important centers they are producing stations, especially concentrating in mango hybridization, is IHR Bangalore and even Perigulum Research Station and the IRI. So IRI actually evolved Amrapali, is one of the variety which has a very dwarf in nature that can be used for identity planting. And Malliga is another variety. Invariably they used Neelam. So Neelam is one of the regular bearer. To avoid the irregular bearing, this Malliga has been evolved. And Arkaruna, Arka Punit is also one of the regular bearer. And the combination with Alfonso as one of the export quality varieties. And Ratna is one of the varieties which divide of these spongy tissues. I already told about the spongy tissues prevailing in Alfonso. Whereas in Ratna, these spongy tissues will not be available. That can be used for using this Alfonso, element Alfonso. So to avoid this, these resistance to spongy tissues. If you take Sindhu, Sindhu is also having the Alfonso as one of the parents. But here, in Sindhu, that seed nut is very papery shells. They may call it as a seedless variety, but strictly say that is a paper shells. That the other varieties released from PKM 1, PKM 2, that is, I already told about that Chinnaswarnareka is used as one of the parents in PKM 1. And the popular varieties in Tamil Nadu, Banganapalli, Bangalore, Neelam, Romani, Malgova, Alfonso, Sendura, Kalapad, Imam Pasanda, I already told. For export purpose is Alfonso, this Banganapalli, Sendura is also used. For processing, Alfonso, Banganapalli, Totapuri are being used. The varieties are all being displayed here. You can go through this. And coming to this, the climatical condition, I already told about it. It is a tropical evergreen tree. And it can also, it cannot grow beyond 600 MSL because of the frost. It doesn't tolerate frost and heavy winds. And the soil type, you can go in for this. It is sandy loamy soil is the best. But there shouldn't be proper drainage, should be there. Stagnation of water is injurious to the tree. And the pH should be around neutral in nature. The method of propagation, if you go for this, normally, if it is in olden days, they use the seeds for propagation. But that seed now, we are using it as a rootstock. The seed is all being used to rootstock, and the method of vegetative propagation is normally in the former levels in arching. The height of this propagated plants will be 10 months old to 12 months old. If you want to have lesser durations of this vegetative propagated crops, they can go for this softwood grafting. Softwood grafting that is normally recommended in commercial scale also by IRI. And epicotyl grafting, the grafting at epicotyl stage of grafting, we produce more number of grads in them, but dwarf in size. But the standards will be in the field will be very less when compared to this softwood and in arching. The time of planting is normally they go for June, July, August, one of the season, because after 6 months when rain is there and during October, November, it can withstand. So that is why it has been chosen as June, July, August, the best season. And the preparation of digger as usual for every crop, you can go for 1 meter into 1 meter, 1 meter cube with farmyard manures. And you can go in by Linden also, some of this insecticide to avoid termite attack and ants attack. Go for this. And spacing, if you calculate it, but the conventional method, 10 into 10 meters, accommodating 40 plants per acre, they go for this. But afterwards, they reduce it to 8 into 80, accommodating 62 plants per hectare, acre. But high-density planting, 5 into meters, you can accommodate nearly about 160 plants. Whereas I told about the Amrapali, you can go for 2.5 meter to 4 meter, closest spacing. And Sendura also is a very stocky HR. Sendura, that can be going for 3 meters into 3 meters also can be adopted, maintaining the canopy management on that. So when you go for the identity planting, canopy management is very, very important. And coming to that, the training, the training has to be, any training has to be carried out in the initial stages. So initial stages, when it grows to height of about 1 meter height, there should not be any side branches. Afterwards, you can have a well-developed, well-spaced 2 to 3 well scaffold branches, you can allow it. And you can maintain the other branches. Then the nutrient applications, normally it is applied in 2 seasons, June, July and October, November, they will go for that. And the schedule also is begin when, and you can very well see that also. I don't go more detail on that. And irrigation management, normally previously they go for open field irrigations. Nowadays, water saving, we can go for drip irrigation, and even more precise, go for this fertigation method of. But application of the organic manures to tree crops is very, very essential in the initial stages. The growth will be very good, and the pest resistance will be more on that if you apply with organic manures as well as the azospirillum, phosphobacteria, and biofertilizers, as well as the trichoderma. Also, which is reduces the incidence of disease also in that. Then, in the initial stages, when go for a new planting, the interspaces can be very well utilized for intercrop, either vegetables or pulses, whatever that is suitable for that area, you can adopt on that. Regarding the bearing, we can call it as a regular bearer or irregular bearer. Some may call it as a binal bearing, and which is on ear or off ear. Most of the North Indian varieties behaves as a binal bearing, is on ear or off ear. On ear means first year it will give a heavy yield, and the subsequent year you will get a very less yield, that is called off ear. And what is the reason behind it? Is that maybe genetical factors or CN ratios or climatical factors and poor management of the region. These are all the some of the reasons for this binal bearing. How to overcome that? So choose the varieties which is a regular bearer. I already told about the regular bearer, Neelam, Bangalore, Amrapali. I told about this Malliga, Ratna. So many varieties are released, the Pig and Mount Pig. These are all regular bearer. So these varieties can be chosen. Then when we can go for this baclofitoxel application, the dosage and everything will be given. It is is normally it is given in this text also that we can use it also. Do you understand? That application of this is a growth retardant, this baclofitoxel. Commercially it is called as Caltar, and chemically we can call it P333. Soil application which induces the flowering, that has been tried not only this mango and other tree crops also, it has been tried with that. But some residual toxicity maybe that has been reported. However, even this application of the growth rate like NA 200 ppm during the on year may help also the regular bearing. And another phenomena is loss, you can go for this fruit drop. That is maybe due to the many factors, embryo abortions or climatical factors or regular irrigations, lack of nutrients, then pest and disease biotic effect. So that may cause us the imbalance. And naturally, it increases the abscisic acid and drop may be there. If it is a drop is there, in the initial stages you can control. But when the latter stages, when the fruits are at somewhat bigger sizes, if the drop is more, the losses will be very heavy on that. So you can spray the LRB9 at the rate of 100 ppm, or sometimes in the younger stage 220 ppm you can recommend it, and 240 we can recommend with 2 grams in 100 liters of water. In the last week of April or the first week of May, we'll control some account about the fruit drop. That is one thing we can go for this. And another physiological disorder is we can go in for this the mango malformation. Mango malformation is malformation means it is reduced in sizes. Either it is vegetative is there, and in the case of floral malformation, it will be, flower will be somewhat misshaped in that. You can't get any fruits also. So that may be, so it has been told that there are many reasons on that. Fungus is also one of the major cause for this also, that for which we can go for the application of this carbon DSM. We can recommend for this 0.1 gram per liter. You can spray that in the initial stages. You can overcome that phenomena of this mango malformations. Then coming to this very important, even there's some important pest they are using it. Important pest, if you come across that, the hopper is one of the important insect at the time of flowering, which creates honey, and there is a yellow flower drop will be there. Then the secondary infection will be your sooty mold. To control this, normally previously they go for the carbaryl plus vegetable sulfur, each 2 grams per, they will spray it. Now they are recommending this endosulfan. Endosulfan now it's being banned, so we can go for acephate. You can 2 grams per liter, if you spray it, you can control that mealybug. Mealybug you can control with the monocotophos, 2 ml per liter. And this rarely fruit flies will be there, a problem in that. In the case of diseases, this is anthracnose, dieback, powdery mildew, red rust, sooty mold. We can control with the appropriate pesticide. A disorder, I already told about the malformation. We have discussed the floral and vegetative malformation. Binary bearing, already told, fruit black. And black tip is one of these physiology. There is a disorder that is a black in color in this surface of these fruits. That may be due to this monoxide, carbon monoxide that is released during this in the Brooklyn, places where the Brooklyn is there, that smoke will causes that. And even a stem also, at the time of plucking also, there is a latex flow will be there. That also one of the melody that it is also attacking the around the neck of the fruits also. This latex will injure the fruits also there. So we have to go in for calcium carbonate solutions, DPT, and that we can also control that also. That you can go for maturity indices. Normally each natural fall of the fruit is one of the indices, or you can go for the softness, firmness of the fruits. We can go in for this and the color changes in the fruits. These are some of the indications we can go for this maturity indices for this mango. And normal yield you can get it to 10 tons per hectare. You can get it, even hybrids you can go for even 15 to 20 tons. You can get it from the hybrids. I think these are the very important key points for your UG level. You can note down all the points what I told, then you can write in the piece of paper and upload it in the Google Classrooms. Next up, we will go for